So what was the Vietnam War really about? Let's start with the basics. In the 1800s, France took over Vietnam. Its neighbors, Laos and Cambodia, were also colonized by the French. Together, they formed their own colony called French Indochina. The people of Vietnam didn't exactly like the idea of being colonized, as many farmers lost their jobs and grew poor. During World War II, a Vietnamese man named Ho Chi Minh started the Viet Minh Army to challenge the French. In 1954, the Viet Minh and France signed a treaty, dividing the country into communist North Vietnam and anti-communist South Vietnam. The government in the South was not very popular with its people. This is where Australia becomes involved, as several Western countries, such as America, Australia and New Zealand, began to provide support to South Vietnam. On August 2nd, 1964, North Vietnam fired torpedoes on an American ship patrolling in the Gulf of Tonkin. The United States President passed the Gulf of Tonkin Resolution, which allowed America to use military force. By the end of 1968, there were over 500,000 troops fighting for the South. The Viet Cong, the communist soldiers in the South, fought a guerrilla war, which the Western countries were not equipped to fight. Back at home, in Australia, many people were not supportive of Australia's involvement in the war. They couldn't understand why Australians had to die for such a sickening cause. Television, newspapers, and magazines brought home pictures of the atrocities of the war. There were still many others, however, who believed in the cause of the war, and they thought that the protesters were putting soldiers at risk by weakening support for them. Eventually, the Western forces stopped sending in more troops, and the war ended in 1973. After the Vietnam War, over 2 million Indochinese people became refugees, and the first boat people arrived in Australia in 1976. Australia had a long history of allowing only immigration of white Europeans. This all changed, however, after the war. Before 1975, there were less than 2,000 Vietnamese people living in Australia. However, in the 10 years following the war, over 90,000 Indochinese refugees came. It is believed that this is a direct result of Australia's involvement in the Vietnam War, as the Liberal government at the time realised that Australia had obligations to the refugees, because of the role Australia played in the war. These decisions paved the way forward, and so began the movement towards a multicultural society that is a fundamental part of our Australian culture. This meant that when the refugees from Indochina began to arrive in the mid-1970s, they entered a country that was making a move towards multiculturalism. The government saw multiculturalism as a way of ensuring that many different cultures could live alongside each other, while at the same time being able to celebrate their own beliefs and traditions.